What is Git? Git is a very common term used in a developer's community. It is called as a version control system. Basically, in a big tech company like Google or Amazon, or even in a small companies also, we have the developers working on the same project. Now, for that one project, we need the synchronization between all the developers. So Git helps us in that. What developers do here is, they write their code, and at the end of the day, they commit their code into the central database, central repository using Git. So it will become easy to track which developer has done which code. There will be a history maintained for each committed code. That is why the version control system is useful. This is how version control system works. Now, version control system is basically divided into two types: centralized version control system and distributed version control system. Now, what is the difference between centralized and distributed? In centralized version control system, all the developers have to be dependent on one server. If that server is down, all the work gets stopped. Developer 1 cannot get access to the developer 2's files. Developer 3 cannot access developer 1 and developer 2 files. There will be no synchronization, no collaboration, not even in a local repository, because of which it will be difficult to manage the project. So that's why mostly distributed version control systems are in existence. What happens in this case here is, there is a server, there is a repository, you can say. All the developers work and commit their code into the central repository. When the server gets down and repository is not live, each developer has its own local repository created using Git, so that whenever server gets up, server gets live, so then all the developers can sync it with the server. So that's why distributed version control system is very helpful in real world. Git is the most commonly used distributed version control system, so that's what we are going to explore in this course. Let's see the Git commands practically using SourceTree. We will create one repository today, and we will create one project, and we will commit that project using the Git commands. Before proceeding to the theory part, let's see the practical purpose of each command so that you can get a clarity how these commands work. First, we will search for the term Bitbucket. Go to the first link here. Login. We are setting the account here at Bitbucket. Once you are logged in, you can see here the create button. Here you have to create the repository. Select project. We will create a new project here. Let's name it as web course project. And let's give it name as learning purpose. And keep the access level as private repository, because if this is public, all the users in the Bitbucket community can see your code and can change the code or delete the code. So private repository is very much recommended here. Keep the rest of the things same, and here create repository. Okay, now here we have this repository learning purpose. Now, download this software for your system, SourceTree. I am here on the Mac, so that's why I am downloading here Mac OS. If you are on the Windows, you can download it from here. Okay, once it is downloaded, I have already downloaded this. So once you are done with the download part, you can see this screen. Okay, now from here, what you have to do is, go to the Bitbucket where you have created the learning purpose directory. You can see the repository here, and here you have to clone this, click on clone, and here you have the option to clone it to your repository. What this clone do is, all the files in this project, in the learning purpose project, will be copied into your system using the source tree. So use this option, clone in source tree, copy in source tree, open source tree to, okay, wherever you want to save this, you can do it from here. Click here. I will save it on in the documents. Create new folder from here. Name it as learning purpose repository repo. Okay, create and open. So you can give your system password here, whatever it is, always allow, and here you can click on clone. This will copy all the files from that learning purpose repository you have created in the Bitbucket here in your system. See, here you have learning purpose repository. Now here you can see it in your folder. Wherever you have saved this, I have saved in documents, learning purpose repository. I will open this in my Visual Studio Code, new window. Drag that folder here. You can open it from here as well. Okay, from here as well open, or you can drag the learning purpose folder here also. Trust the authors. See, here you can see a git ignore file. This is the first file which is created whenever you clone your project from the Bitbucket using source tree. What we will do here is, we will create one file, name it as index.html. This is a sample file. We will commit this file. Okay, here we will write one HTML code, a basic HTML code, heading tag. See, now this file is in your local system, right? How to commit this so that we can see the files here as well? So open the source tree. See, you can see index.html file is added in this learning purpose directory, right? So this is your local copy. Now here you have to click this checkbox here, add commit message. My first file created and I am committing. Write the purpose of this file to the, you can write anything here depending on the message of this file. This is a heading file. This file will print heading. Okay, click on push changes immediately to origin master. From here you can do this push change, or from here as well you can do this push change. What this push change will do is, it will push all the files to the server, to the central repository here. Using push command you can achieve that. And what does this commit do is, it will commit the changes whatever you have done in that file. So I will click on commit here, confirm, add, done. So here we have committed our first file to the server, to the central repository using source tree. So here on the left side you can see the commits here, right? So this is a file I can track now. Like, this is the first file which you have created. Even if your system gets formatted now, your code will be available there, right? This is the advantage. When even if your system gets formatted, all the code will be available here. So you can access that project in another system as well. So it is an easy way to maintain the code. Here you can see, if you click on the commit, you can see this is a file being created, index.html, and the code is being written inside this file, right? 58 seconds. You can even track the time, like when the file is being committed, everything will be online here, right? Now what we will do is we will change some content here and save it. Inside source tree you can see like you have changed something here. Now we will commit the change. I changed some content inside my heading tag. Make sure to add this file index.html and click on the push changes immediately to origin master. Suppose if I do not click on this push change here, I will commit this. Okay, so here you can see a push contains one. Now this is not committed to the central repository here. If you can click here, you cannot see the changes here, right? This is the first commit which we have done. So we have to push that change here. Push it. Okay. Once you push the code, then only you can see your commits here. See, I changed some content inside my heading tag. And what are the changes? This is your change, right? This is the benefit of using Git. Now, this click is called as Git add. Okay, so that's what we are going to see in the theory part. There are steps to commit the file, to push the file. Okay, so first what we will do is first we add it, then commit it, and commit it, and then push it. So these are the steps. First add to the index, this is our index, then commit, and then push. These are the steps if you are using the terminal, using the command prompt, you can use this way. But I will recommend you to use this source tree. This is very helpful and handy, and all the developers use this. But you must know these commands, because sometimes what happens is source tree shows some error inside your code and you will not be able to commit your code using source tree sometimes. So in that case, you must know the commands through which you can commit the code, right? So we will see that in the theory part. I hope you got the practical part very clear. All you have to do is first go to the Bitbucket, create repository, login from here, create a repository from here, okay, and then download source tree for your system. Once it is downloaded, you can click, go to your repository here, click on clone here, and here you can clone in source tree. Wherever you want to clone this, you can clone it inside your system, and then open Visual Studio Code and add the folder here, create one file and see the changes are happening inside your repository or not, and then add it, commit it, and push it. This is how this process works. In the next episode, what we will do is we will understand what is Angular and what is Node.js, what is npm. Using that, we will create our first Angular project inside this repository, learning purpose repository, and we will do our complete project of online learning course in this repository only. We will create two projects in this course. We will commit all the projects inside this repository only, so that we both can collaborate. Okay. Let's have a quick review of what we have done practically. If you remember, we have cloned our repository into the project, right? So using git clone URL, you can do that stuff. Git add file. If you remember, we have added the files to the index, add to the index, then commit and then push. So git add and the name of the file will add that file to the index. Git commit dash m means message, and whatever message you have to write about the file, you have to add that. So first was add to index, commit, and the third one is push. And the third one is git push. So using this, you can push the file to the central repository. Now if you want to get that file once you have created the repository, you have to use the git pull command. There is an option in source tree, if you notice, before push there was a pull also. Okay. We will see this in practical once we create an Angular project. I hope you got an idea about how we push the project files to the central repository and handle the project. Source tree is the best way to use the commits. Instead of writing the heavy commands and keeping the note of it every time, this is the best way.